this tutorial, I'll show you how to make these sand art jars. I love this project because it gave me an opportunity to recycle some of these old candle jars that I had laying around, and the rest of the supplies are really easy to find, and you probably already have them in your house.
For this project, you'll need some chalk pastels, a decorative jar, a plain jar to mix your different colors in, some table salt, small containers for different colors, a sheet of paper, some tape, a hot glue gun and hot glue, and something pointy like a chopstick. You may also want to use a knife. Start by putting about 1/8 cup of salt into your jar and tossing in one of your chalk pastels. Then shake it until all of that salt turns the color of the pastel. You don't want to be too violent with it because then you'll shatter your chalk pastel. Once you've gotten it to the color that you like, put it into one of your containers that you're using to separate your colors and take out the pastel and put it away. Do as many colors as you think you're going to want for your project. Another fast method to do this that's a little bit more dangerous is to just shave off a little bit of your chalk pastel into the jar using your knife. If you're a child, have your parents do this instead, and then shake it up and you get a nice saturated color. Once you've premixed all of those colors, go ahead and roll up your sheet of paper at an angle. You'll want to do this at an angle because you're forming a cone that you're going to use as a funnel. So make sure that the tip of it is not too large, otherwise the sand is going to fall right through. Then tape it up towards the end, make sure there aren't any weird folds that are going to get stuck, and you're ready to begin. Start by putting a mound of salt into the bottom of your glass jar. You don't want this mound to reach all the way to the edges, just leave a little gap, and then fill in that gap with your first color. I just did some blue for the ocean on my first pass around. Then I built up that center cone. You're going to want to do this so you don't end up wasting all of your colored salt because this is a lot less work. I did different shades of blue and green, and then I started adding in my islands. I did a little strip of black sand, then put a mound of my yellow beachy colored sand on top of that, covered that up with another thin stripe of black, and then I added a slightly larger island behind that one using the exact same method. I filled up the ocean a little bit around it, being careful not to get it over the island, and then finished up the top of the island with another thin black strip. Then I built up the center of the jar, being sure not to get any of that sand to the edge, and then I continued with my different layers of ocean colors. I turned the jar around and did another island on the other side of the jar, built up the center a little bit more, and then I started with my birds. I just did a little tiny stripe of black sand and then pushed the center of it down with my chopstick, and then covered it up with the same color that was underneath the birds. I did a couple of clouds and then filled the rest in with different shades of the sky colors. Once your jar is completely full, pat down the sand, wait about 24 hours, top it off a little bit more because the sand will settle and you don't want a gap at the top. Once you've completely filled it with sand, go ahead and glue on your lid with your hot glue gun. And that's all there is to it. I ended up doing another version with a nice little sunset scene, but you can do anything you want or even just do crazy stripes of color. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, remember to like, share, and subscribe, and check out my channel for other fun DIY projects.